Welcome back. You're watching Money, Money, Money. And this week, we are profiling the biggest mutual fund schemes of this country. Two of them happen to be the top two, that is, from the HDFC universe. And so does the third. That brings us down. I'll actually quickly do a recap if you're joining us now. The biggest mutual fund scheme of the country, HDFC Prudence, has assets under management of almost 38,000 crore rupees. After that, we discussed the HDFC Equity Fund, and now we are down to the HDFC Mid-Cap Opportunities Fund. Feroze, more about the scheme.
HDFC Mid-Cap Opportunity amazes me, the way it has been managed. Mm-hmm. Chirag Setalwad is the fund manager, of course, is part of the team of Prashant Jain's team. So I think the way he has managed a mid-cap scheme at 21,000 crores almost is stupendous. What happens is, unlike the other two schemes, these schemes have hardly any intersection, largely because the categorization is different. That is large cap and balanced. This one is mid cap. You have Cholamandalam, you have Sundaram, you have different kinds of stocks which have zero intersection. So this is a super scheme in my opinion. And so far, it has not shown any disadvantage of size, and I hope that it will continue for the next 1, 2, 3 years in the same fashion. In my opinion, again, they have a bottom-up stock picking strategy. Bottom-up stock picking is very critical in a mid-cap fund. Mm-hmm. In a large-cap fund, in my opinion, the strategy should be top-down, choosing the sector first and then the stock.
Sure.
But that's what is meant by top-down. Bottom-up means choosing the stock first and being agnostic to sector. So it has a very, very good bottom-up stock picking. Third point which I want to make is the decisions which Chirag Setalwad has taken in this fund, the past 100 decisions if you analyzed, because he's managing this from 2007.
Right.
So he would have taken several investment and disinvestment decisions.
Mm-hmm.
The number of right decisions to the wrong decisions taken is amazing.
Okay.
Right? That's the one thing which should be measured. But for a benefit of the viewers, I'm just saying the synopsis and lack of time, that the right decisions are significantly more than the wrong decisions.
So basically, Chirag gets it right far more than he gets it wrong. And that's a great thing to, of course, have as a fund manager. Some of the top holdings, I'm just looking at what this fund owns. Cholamandalam Investments, Sundaram Fasteners, Balkrishna Industries, Voltas, Hexaware, RBL Bank. It's a varied mix of stocks that is part of this fund. Return analysis as well. I mean, 5 years, we're talking, what, 27-28%? That's far better than the underlying index, the mid-cap index, right?
Correct. So HDFC's fund management capability, if given wings and a larger canvas, has always proved better. In mid-cap space, you have a larger canvas. In large-cap space, you have to mirror the index. So it's not Prashant Jain's capability used there. Because Prashant Jain's capability is right up there. You have to give it a mandate which is flexible enough. And that's what this fund does.
Okay.
And so return, they've beaten the benchmark by 4% last 1 year as well. Which shows up. So my recommendation, HDFC Mid-Cap Opportunities and HDFC Small-Cap Fund in the HDFC category could be a good replacement to the large-cap and the balance fund in their same basket.
All right. So we have done the top three, and all these top three funds happen to be from HDFC Asset Management Company. Let's come to the fourth biggest fund of India. And this one is the Aditya Birla Sun Life Frontline Equity. Huge numbers here as well. We're talking assets under management in excess of 20,000 crore rupees. So this one, I'm guessing, managed by Mahesh Patil.
Mahesh Patil manages it since 2005 November.
Mm-hmm.
And you can very clearly see wherever the fund manager has stuck on for more than a decade, those end up becoming large schemes.
Yeah.
So there's something to infer from here. So Mahesh Patil has managed this for 13 years and he's, of course, done a great job because of the size. It is, again, not in my recommendation list. It has fallen prey to this large fund size. So in the Birla category, I would want to be quick and inform the viewers that Birla Equity Fund is a good replacement to Birla Frontline because the fund management team and the capability, because the CEO of this has always been a fund manager. Bala has been a fund manager. So it's a technical guy running the company.
Sure.
And I think they've done very, very good justice. So then looking at the funds and sector, of course, you can look at sectors which are financial services, the usual suspect in a large cap scheme, consumer cyclicals. And the third one is technology, of course, and consumer defensives are these four top sectors of this fund.
Let's now move down to the next one, which is the Kotak Select Focus, also a very, very popular fund. We get lots of queries on this. Again, a very big fund as well. We're talking 19,000 crores here. One of the marquee funds from the Kotak universe. Your opinion and analysis of this?
Kotak is managed by Harsh Upadhyay, mm-hmm. a very good fund manager. And again, when you look at his right to wrong ratio, mm-hmm. which tells the credibility of the fund manager, is very, very good. And he, since it is a large cap scheme and 19,000 crores, and how they have countered their problem of being so large mm-hmm. has been commendable again. So it's a recommended scheme, and you can still continue to hold the scheme for the next couple of years mm-hmm. because it's a flagship scheme of mm-hmm. Kotak. Mm-hmm. Unlike in the HDFC basket, you have three schemes mm-hmm. which are large. Mm-hmm. Here, Kotak has one large scheme, and the second large scheme might be right down there.
Okay.
Not that there's so much attention needed in three different schemes. So Kotak Select Focus continues to be my recommendation.
Okay.
And Anand Rathi's ranking gives it the top quartile, not on the basis of past performance, but future indicators.
Okay.
So statistically, you can analyze the future from the past data. That's called regression analysis. That also throws up a good output to it. So recommended scheme, Harsh Upadhyay is a fund manager in the large cap space, 19,000 crores.
Mm.
And over the last couple of years, it has done justice and it has outperformed the Nifty reasonably well.
Mm.
And the risk ratios are lower than the Nifty in certain cases. So that's a good risk return reward.
So what is it that Harsha and his team are doing differently? Because this is also a very big lot size fund.
Mm.
But despite that, you're willing to overlook your, you know, don't go in for a very big fund rule. To go in for the select focus. So what do you think is happening differently here which makes this fund stand out?
They are top down.
Okay.
They're not bottom up.
Okay.
Large cap schemes should be top down in strategy. They've got their sector allocation right.
Hmm.
And the stock selection, they've been unconventional. And they have moved away from the benchmark indices.
Mm-hmm.
Like Nifty and Sensex are good benchmarks for large cap funds.
Mm-hmm.
They've moved from their benchmark. They have shown courage
mm-hmm.
to be away from the benchmark and still beat it. And I think that's where the fund manager's fee becomes justifiable. If I have to replicate the benchmark, I actually don't need to pay 2.5-3%. So moving away from the benchmark, having a top down, these are two core reasons why I think it's still not late enough to enter the scheme.
All right, well, we have to take another break on that note, but we're not done yet. We are analyzing some of the biggest funds of India. We have one more fund for you, and this one is from the State Bank of India universe, the SBI MF universe. We'll be back with the analysis in just a moment.